morning and welcome to worship, and we're glad to have you with us online today as we are celebrating the Lord and all that He does for us in this wonderful day. For our words of greeting, I'd like to offer you these, and if you'll put those up here. We gather together in the name of the one who bids us come. We gather together to hear the words of the one who is love. We gather together to sing praises of the one who teaches peace. Come, let us worship. Let us enter into a time of prayer. O God, we gather together in your presence with expectation, hungry for an encounter with you, eager to hear your word. Open our eyes and ears to the presence of your Holy Spirit. May the seeds of your words scattered among us this morning fall on fertile soil, and may they take root in our hearts and lives and produce an abundant harvest of good words and deeds. We pray this in the name of Jesus Christ, our teacher and our Lord. Amen. Let us sing our first hymn. Time of sharing of our gifts, we continually invite you to share any gifts that you have to this church. Anytime that you'd like to sing, maybe share a word of faith, a word of hope, or even a testimony at some time, we would invite you to come and to share on any Sunday morning in those things. We also are not in a place where we're semi-gathering together, but we still are thankful to those folks who continue to give to the church and share your offerings into this time to help the ministries of this congregation as we continue to navigate through this period of time and this season that we are in these days. As we think about these gifts and the gifts that you might offer, let us offer God this prayer. As we offer our gifts and lives in this moment, may we become imitators of you, gracious God, who holds nothing back from us, but is generous and gracious with all that is yours. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our scripture for the morning comes from the book of Psalm. It'd be Psalm chapter 119. And be reading verses 105 through 112. And I think you might recognize some of the words in the midst of this. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. I have sworn an oath and confirmed it, to keep your righteous rules. I am severely afflicted. Give me life, O Lord, according to your word. Accept my freewill offerings of praise, O Lord, and teach me your rules. I hold my life in my hand continually, but I do not forget your law. The wicked have laid a snare for me, but I do not stray from your precepts. Your testimonies are my heritage forever, for they are the joy of my heart. I incline my heart to perform your statutes forever to the end. And may we be blessed with the reading of God's word. We'd like to give you time now to just enter into a reflective moment as we enter into prayer. This will be our morning prayer as we share our joys and concerns and just be mindful of those persons, those events, those activities, whatever it might be that you have in your life going on now, that you be in prayer for those. We give you just a moment in silence to kind of reflect upon those, and then I will close us in a time of prayer. We thank you, God, for listening to us, for hearing our words, for hearing the groans of our spirits as we have met together, whether it's in the congregation or whether it's a time of meeting in our homes or wherever it might be. We are so thankful that we can continually gather together as the congregation. In this season of the year, the season of time that we are in, where things are sort of a little different as our gatherings have been decreased, almost non-existent at times, but that we're able to just be with you in spirit as well as visually through our computers, our cell phones, or even maybe plugged into our TV somehow. We are just thankful that we can have these things so that we can continue to worship you and to be a part of this church in the midst of it all. God, we give you thanks for those activities of life, those things that we are able to participate in, and just the goodness that you have for us to allow us to work, to play, to engage with others and do the things that you call us to do. But we're also mindful of those in our congregation and in our midst who are sick, who are recovering in the midst of some rehab, who are preparing for surgery, who may have come out of surgeries, who find themselves in a hospital or just leaving the hospital. For those who are grieving, we just lift them to you, God. God, we give you thanks for all that we can do and all that we can say, for the comfort that we can offer, for the encouragement that we can give, for the words of hope that we might share with others. We thank you for who you are and for what you do. For it is in Christ's name that we do pray. Amen. Little story says this. It says, God is talking to one of his angels and says, "Do you know what I have just done? I have just created a 24-hour period of alternating light and darkness on earth. Isn't that good?" The angel says, "Yes, but what do you do now?" God says, "I think I'll call it a day." Oh, during this time we've been in, many folks have found opportunities to do a little extra home improvement, whether that's fixing up the house or a little needed landscaping that goes with it. Being asked to stay at home has allowed more time to get some of those projects accomplished. I know for us, we have done some of those things ourselves. And one of those has been to put some landscape rock out in the front of the house. And we're doing this to eliminate that yearly putting down of mulch. So the other night, we finally got our new solar lights spread around the walk in this newly landscaped area. And we really enjoy going out that evening to see the project glowing in the darkness. Solar lights are an interesting thing to have, are they not? Because we put them along our sidewalks, along our driveway, along a path that we might have in our places behind our homes, wherever it might be. If we live in a wooded area, we use them down those pathways. We do that so it gives light in the midst of darkness, so that it helps illuminate our path and the way that we walk along that path. It gives that extra bit of light so that we don't trip or stumble or fall on some object, on some branch, on some impediment that might be a distraction or a stumbling block if it was completely dark in that moment. You see, light is very important, isn't it? We have lights in our home. Our cars have headlights, brake lights, tail lights. Even the interior has a light so that we can see as we get inside the car and know what we need to do. Light is important. And as the story of the little joke said, God did create that light, but he did it to separate the darkness. And it's interesting that we see that in our psalm this morning. Our psalm that immediately begins with those words that say, "Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path." Letting us understand the importance of God's word to us as it becomes a lamp, as it becomes this illuminating function, this illuminating spirit, this illuminating thing that causes us to walk out of darkness, to help us penetrate through that darkness so that we can see our sinfulness, but we can also see our way to Jesus Christ. Light has a very important function in the scriptures themselves. Jesus says we're a city set upon a hill so that we might be that light to the city below. Some of us enjoy trips to the beach, and especially the Outer Bank areas and some of these others that have the lighthouses. And lighthouses are very cool. Lighthouses are not utilized anymore in the way that they used to be because our ships have modern navigation and GPS and all of these things that help, and sonar to help them be guided through particular areas to get them close to shore so that they don't get tangled on rocks and get broken and sink. But before these modern technologies, ships relied on lighthouses to guide them into beach areas, into these rugged, rocky alcoves that might be there close to shore. It illuminated that pathway so that that ship would know not to get too close. You see, Jesus even talks about that there's a narrow way and a wide way. And imagine that that narrow way is kind of like that little path that you have that has those solar lights, that you need that little bit of section, but you need that little bit of light to walk down it so that we might recognize who we are, that we might recognize ourselves, and we might recognize the fact that we share this in common with God. That the word that we read, the word that we study, the word that we spend time together navigating through is what lights our pathway. And by doing so, we light the path for others. That we become that illuminating spirit, that illuminating figure for others, so that they too might discover who they are as a person who needs to have faith, who needs to know Jesus, who needs to share in that repentance that helps them so that they too might walk that same path. We are blessed with the words from the psalmist. And the psalmist continues on with a lot of different areas within this particular text. And a lot of it is still related to this word, this lamp, this light to my path. And it's a teaching lesson for the people to be reminded of all the things that God has given beforehand. It talks about the word. It talks about rules. It talks about law. It talks about precepts. It talks about the statutes. And for the Jewish people, those people of Israel, they were counted on these and relied on these for their daily life. Now we know when Jesus came that it was becoming overbearing to them because of how the teachers and the people of religious law were using them and abusing them and mistreating them spiritually at times. But Jesus did not say that he came to destroy the law, but to be the law. And the law that he is, the guiding force that he is that lamp for our feet, guiding us in our daily walk with him. Solar lights are such a great way to enhance the looks of your house. But it's so much fun to see that light that it permeates from them and shines within that darkness. I remember when we used to be scouts and we would go out and we'd go camping. And there were times that we didn't have our flashlights. Big mistake, wasn't it? But we relied on the moon sometimes for light. At church camp, we used to always take our flashlights down these paths that we would go down, because you could sometimes hear people behind going, boom, boom, boom. Well, they fall in a trip because they did not have their light. We need the Word of God. We need to hear what it says. We need to read what it says. We need to study what it says. And we need to continually allow that to be upon our hearts and upon our spirits in a daily basis, a weekly basis, an always basis, so that we know how to interact with others, so that we know how to engage with others, so that we know how to live with others. Because in this life that we have, we aren't the only one. And God is trying to, and Jesus is trying to improve who we are as His people, as disciples, as faithful people who are teaching others what it means to follow the Word. Because there are a lot of people who are just stumbling around in this moment, who are stumbling around in the darkness, trying to find their way, who don't have access to the light. Well, maybe we shouldn't say that, should we? They have access. It's just they haven't received it. They haven't maybe desired it. They maybe haven't heard it yet. We as God's people, we who are the city who stands upon the hill, we who are the lighthouse, we who are like the Word, we are there to light the way. We are like that lamp that illuminates through the darkness and shines a light so others might see. Jesus tells us He is the light of the world. The song says that we too have the light of the world. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. As we go from this place and this day, let us be mindful of that, and let us too shine our light. Shine it daily. Shine it so others might see and might live the life that they've been called to do. In Jesus' name, amen. Our closing hymn will be "When We Walk with the Lord." Let us sing. Benediction, I would like to read this same text, but I'd like to read it from the Message, Eugene Peterson's translation of the Word. By your words, I can see where I am going. They throw a beam of light on my dark path. I've committed myself, and I'll never turn back from living by your righteous order. Everything's falling apart on me, God. Put me together again with your Word. Festoon me with your finest sayings, God. Teach me your holy rules. My life is as close as my own hands, but I don't forget what you have revealed. The wicked do their best to throw me off track, but I don't swerve an inch from your course. Go in his peace. Amen.